Despite an increasing number of people preferring e-books, bookstores in Singapore say their business is sustainable, and one has even seen sales grow over the last 5 years. The stores say the basics of retail must be right, and they must constantly think of new ways to get people through the door. MPH announced last week that it is closing its 2 outlets in the country, citing high rental costs, but it will restructure and reopen at a new location. Gwyneth Teo tells us more.
If one looks at the numbers, more people are reading books, physical or electronic ones. A 2018 survey showed that 25% of adults read a book more than once a week, a 6% increase from 2016. However, the same survey revealed that a growing number of people prefer e-books. Fewer people also bought books from a physical store, falling from 53% to 48%.
Booksellers say the issues facing bookstores are the same as with any other retail business: rising rental costs and a slowing retail economy. So they say they must find new ways to reach out to readers and give them what they want.
Books actually has been around for 14 years. Over the past 5 years, it has seen an annual growth of 2% to 3%. That's because it has been relentlessly reaching out to buyers, new and old.
You reach out to the person at 16 years old and tell them you exist. You know, maybe they were, you had held some school talk and then they had to come to the bookstore. 8, 9 years down the road, I still need to market to that same person, and now it's even more important because this person now is in the working industry and has a bigger disposable income. We can reach out via events. Sometimes we, on the odd mood swing, we actually end up doing a flash sale. You know, the idea is to let people know that we exist.
Books Kinokuniya says the basics of retail are still crucial: ambiance, a good range of products, and customer service. It told CNA that the Singapore flagship store in Ngee Ann City is still the chain's highest grossing store outside of Japan, and that business here has been sustainable over the past few years. Outside of Japan, it has 31 stores in 9 countries, with 3 new stores set to open next year. Its senior store director says that the brand's success lies in its ability to connect with anyone who needs or simply loves books. Some industry players feel more can be done to help booksellers as well. Asia Pac Books has been publishing in Singapore for 35 years, and its manager says there needs to be a proper system to track sales of books here in Singapore.
What we can probably benefit from would be more consolidated data for the market. It would really benefit us a lot more to kind of adopt international or local standards for our book data, so that, you know, it's easier for us to be more transparent about the sales figures, and also so that we can understand the impact of online retailers in a much more complete sense.
Yet it's clear that selling books is not just about numbers and figures. There is an emotional draw to bookstores that comes with the art of reading itself.
Quite a majority of Singaporeans did grow up with the existence of MPH bookstore. When someone passes the old building, the Stamford building, you know, and you will have fond memories of MPH there. It's always that sense of nostalgia.
MPH opened its first store in Singapore in the 1890s.